I'm playing no healer. No healer's fun.
I like no healer with 1-2 power. Okay. 4-1-1.
For Mafia, 1 cop, 1 vigilante, no...
Yeah, I really like that setup.
1 KP.
Okay. So 4 Mafia, 1 cop, 0 medics, 1 vigilante.
Yes.
Okay.
Let's do this.
1 kill power the whole game for both sides.
Well, I have returned.
Okay, we don't have anyone else joining us, right? This is it.
I think this is it.
Okay. Anyone else can play game 2 if they want.
So, for those of you who may be new to watching Mafia, check out esportsmafia.com for rules. But basically, we have 4 people who are Mafia. Everyone else is Town. During the night phase, Mafia tries to kill Town. Oh, well, they do kill Town members one at a time. And during the day phase, everyone argues about who's Mafia. The thing is, no one in Town knows who Mafia is, and Mafia knows who each other are. So people sit, you know, will argue about who's Mafia and who's not based on reads, language reads, etc., etc. And
someone's getting
it's
salty.
Basically trying to catch other people in mistakes.
You guys really gonna play salty bets?
What's that, Carlton? Carlton's a little salty.
Have you got a wound with a little salt in it?
No, I know how Mafia is played, so I don't have to listen to the setup.
Okay, I am just rolling holes.
Did you lose your really aggressive bet of $40, Carlton?
Dude, I had a dollar, and I lost it.
Oh, that's great. It's tragic, man.
Yeah. I'm not going to bet big while I'm playing Mafia, no way. It's a dollar every match.
Okay, I have all the rolls, so would everyone please go to sleep? And I will assign roles in Skype chat.
Oh, yeah, someone open up the Brolagio.
Mango.
Okay, all roles have been assigned. Please double check your Skype to make sure that you guys have your roles. And Mafia, please tell me who you want to kill. Vigilante, please tell me who you want to shoot, if anyone, but please tell me no shot or I want to shoot so-and-so. And Cop, please tell me who you'd like to check. What the hell is Alan saying? We are just now waiting on the Mafia members to confirm their kill. Everyone in chat, hello, how are you all doing? Just waiting a few more minutes. All right. Everybody, please wake up with the exception of Foolishness. Foolishness, also known as Phil, you are dead.
I never get to play with Chef.
Oh.
That's a pretty strong accusation.
That's quite sad.
You think that was a soft claim that he was cop and I'm Mafia?
That was a pretty good kill. I probably would have killed Phil too.
So wait, is there only one KP or did...
One KP.
It's one KP.
Okay, I must have missed that when I was...
Oh, what's the setup again? It's three Mafia...
Four Mafia. One no medic.
Right.
Okay. Alright.
Mango, Circle of Trust, let's do it. Me and you will clear the town of Mafia.
Rhaegor, what's your 5-second read?
Yeah,
sorry,
you're here.
Chat, but...
Got reads.
I'm going to have to go tofu on you. I can't trust you.
My 5-second read is, I can't believe Cameron didn't know about 2-1 KP. That seems weird to me. That was
how do you feel about Mango not knowing how many Mafia there are?
He doesn't know about the setup.
I didn't know about 1 KP.
I'm telling you what I thought 5 seconds into the game. I don't have too much.
Okay.
Just telling you what I thought.
I didn't know the setup either. Notice
Mango did not know how many Mafia were in the game?
I didn't know what the setup was.
At least that's on the overlay.
So Chef didn't know the setup, so Mafia circle around Cameron and Chef right now? Is that what we're saying?
No, I think we should just dismiss it all because it's easy to have misinformation.
Who said Chef? I never said Chef. Nobody said Chef.
The only person that ever said Chef was...
I have a question for Chef.
When he got killed.
Yeah. Seth?
What's up?
Who did you say you're going to make a circle in with the game with?
If you're a town,
you know your town, but how are you so sure his town?
Look at him. I mean,
the only way you no, there's no one no, no, know.
I want nothing to do with Chef right now, so please let me out of here.
Come on, buddy, go down with me. No, you want to.
Didn't you learn from me and Unctuous? Just start accusing him, it'll be fine.
What up, ZNF?
Hey, I just want to ask actually really quick. Do we have one lint or two?
One
kill power on all sides.
Okay. Just making sure.
We usually do that when we have over 15 town at the start of a day.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I said I was betting before this started, but nobody else seems to know what's going on.
Right. And Ben Carlton's on point, and he was salty.
He was salty, yeah.
Carlton's just a permanent state of salt.
Carlton's just on his game, though. He just pays attention before the round start because he's very analytical. It makes sense.
Alan, are you going to talk this game?
Possibly.
Who is smooth ass Kiwi?
That's Daniel Geese, man.
Is it okay? He's the Kiwi.
Yeah.
The token Kiwi. Every show has one.
Jason, you taking notes? What are you doing?
Yeah, taking notes. Lots of beard strokes going on.
Okay.
Beard strokes?
Lots of beard strokes going on. Too bad I already shaved. You are one of them. You and Rhaegor. I always shave my face, though. Rhaegor was telling you that.
This is my sleuthing stroke.
Also, Rob and Unctuous were the only two keeping like a super straight face when we were all laughing at jokes earlier.
Maybe
they just don't find anything
totally
funny.
I'm totally okay with voting off Unctuous.
It is.
Why?
You know what? Circle of trust or not, I'm okay with that too, Mango. Like,
This is weird. We're literally just way too dangerous.
He said to ask who is
I'm
not okay.
I'm not liking what's happening here.
I don't think anyone would say he's not okay to kill Unctuous first day. Like,
I don't know. I tend to be useful one way
no,
or another.
No. It tends to be dangerous.
Dude, if Unctuous was top, he would have come out by now. So.
With a town race.
Do we all agree with what Neil said the other day about one cop is worth one Mafia?
No.
It depends on the setup, I think. It's kind of context sensitive.
Right, because there's more Mafia now, so you're going to... It's good to get that trade day one and not...
I think a lot of times it is, but not 100%.
Not day one with 15...
I think with one KP, you can take the risk and survive it.
Even though there's no medic, if you come out the second day and you had a cop check day one, and like if someone tries to lynch you on day two, your cop claim, even if you are a real cop, doesn't make it like it seems weak, like a cop out. Like, oh no, actually, guys, I'm cop. I got a Mafia check day one. You know, it's really hard to come back from that as cop.
I mean, so it's hard. Your job as cop is to get at least one mafia.
It's like, always really easy. Yeah. It's always right. So
if you get at least one, then you've done your job.
And, well, anything beyond that is taking a risk, because the more that you, the longer you don't come out, the longer you don't come out, the more likely that you're either going to get lynched or killed by mafia.
You should use whatever knowledge you glean as cop to analyze, you know, everyone else.
Oh, and it's the game, like, mafia meta right now.
Yeah,
we can discuss it.
No, I just want to. I just want to cut in really quick. I don't want to change the topic too much. But speaking of analyzing people, I think I've played with almost everyone here except for Jason. So can anyone give me like a
Jason with an eye
on him? Jason with an eye. Jason with an eye. Yeah, yeah. Jason with an eye.
Oh. Is impossible to read.
Why?
Oh, every time you think
why am I impossible to read though?
Every time you think Jason with an eye is mafia, he's actually just like playing bad clown. And every time you think that he's not, he is mafia.
No.
But the one fucking time when he was cop and everyone thought he was
impossible to read, I don't agree.
I'm a terrible cop.
Yeah.
That's true.
But he's terrible town when he fakes cop when he's town, but
dude, that was the best move I ever, like, best move in the game.
That was
fake cop.
That was kind of sweet.
Jason's never a good move. Around his town, generally, he makes pretty good decisions, and he's pretty useful as town.
Thank you.
So unreadable.
Yeah. But he's unreadable, right? So you don't know if
I don't think he's unreadable.
He's a good asset.
I don't know, though. I've heard people say that, like, I think it was Carlson the other day say that he, like, had something on me that would make him... He said
nobody's unreadable. Like a tell? Do you mean like a tell? Like
yeah,
a
tell on that.
It's kind of... It's like a tell. It's like a soft read. Like, he's not, Jason with an eye is not impossible to read. That's
I want to talk bit about Philip dying. I think... So Philip, for me, is literally... I know I was using it to back up my cop play last week, but he really is my easiest read. And so maybe somebody was killing him, and maybe it's other people's easy reads. Maybe somebody killed him in order to get him out of the town circle of trust for those of us who do play often.
Well, he is a strong town, so it's possible.
He's also a strong town.
On the other hand, like he's for, I don't know, he's... The time that you said that he was easy to read, it had to do with only because of the fact that he was like smiling big. But for me, like, he's a difficult read because of the fact that he's kind of always smirking and always smiling. And I don't know that he's as an easy of a read as you're making him out to be.
Okay. I have gotten good reads off of him, but I can't always read him. Like, if that makes sense.
Sure.
Yeah, that makes sense.
How can you say he's a good read when he was like calling the cop the other game and they're like, nope, you're faking, and then it killed him. He was actually the cop. Like, if he was easy to read, you could read that he was the real cop. I mean,
well, that time I was mafia and I was throwing suspicion his way.
Yeah.
During that,
Sheth wanted to say something. By the way, Sheth wants to talk.
Yeah. Regardless of whether it goes through or not, I'm gonna go ahead and formal Kiwi. He's not said a word. He's been eating food. I do want to say like that.
He does mute a lot in the early rounds. He keeps muted.
Yeah, great. It's like no information. I'm fine with either way, even if it's town. Like, he's not being helpful. There's no way I'm going to tell if he's mafia. Like,
sure. I just wanted to let you know that it's not.
I'm done eating now. It's fine.
I'm done eating now. Hey,
that's been the worst thing.
I'm done eating too, but I was eating the whole time.
How long have we been in this round for? I'm out of idea. I talked for 5 minutes as opposed to 15 minutes.
It was like 10.
No idea.
10 minutes.
I was just curious.
I'm picturing like real life. Like, let's say this is real life and we're in a town and there's a guy like just scarfing his face. And I was like, we should probably kill that guy. And he's like, I'm done
eating.
Drops his chicken leg and is like.
There's not heaps to say. I mean, Phil, this is a fine kill. There's plenty of people you could kill night one, no medic. So you've got a pick of whatever. If it was me, one of the big three. Probably like Sheth, Mango, Ryan, but that's just me. Other than that,
I'm sorry, no. You're breaking up. Are those reads, or are those like people you wouldn't mind killing?
Would have killed if he was mafia on that one.
Okay, all right, it wasn't.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, I don't know what's up with my internet. Right. Other than that, I've been trying to look around and see who's intent on watching faces, because that's, to me, indicative of town. I haven't really seen anyone besides Sheth
staring too intently, but I mean, it's kind of hard to tell with some of you where the monsters are. And I'm okay with killing Anxious.
Isn't everybody?
Yeah. I think you're permanently just paying penance for the time you fake claimed cop to the end.
you're just always to be fair, that was the fault of people. Was cop,
and that was the last week I played. I took off a week, so that's just where I'm left off mentally with this.
Wait, we're in a film right now, right? We're actually in a film.
Yeah,
we are. Yes.
Okay.
Ricky.
And I definitely will rescind it if Mango wants me to, because we're best buddies. So
I was actually going to ask Mango. Wait, I was actually interested.
So, what's going on, Mango?
Chef, aren't you just best buddies with Mango?
I have no opinion on Kiwi.
I get it,
I will not be voting on him, but you guys are free to vote whichever way you want. You know,
so we're not voting on Mango.
So what do you want your friend to do?
Well, he said we're not doing it, so let's not do it. Thank you, Mango.
I mean, I really think Chef could be Mafia, because I don't know why he's trying to insinuate that we're like a Mafia circle or something, because that's what he's doing.
No,
we're a town circle.
How do you know his town, Chef?
I wouldn't read into it too seriously, but didn't Chef say last time I played with him that he likes to joke deflect a lot when he is Mafia?
I did.
Alright.
And I mean, I don't know how he can kind of come out right now and say that I'm town.
I'm not saying you're town.
Let's be town buddies.
Just don't kill me, Mafia. Worry about it.
What the fuck?
Oh no, it's a little suspicious.
It's kind of sketch.
That's not what you said at all.
I would say the whole dynamic between the two is suspicious, and don't write one off without checking together.
That's the smartest thing I've heard yet.
Eric, how do you feel that Chef's approaching your point?
It's obvious Chef is more sketchy than me, so please check him, not me.
Say it one time, Rob.
Why shouldn't we check you, Mango? Do you have something to hide?
No, it'll be a waste of a cop check, though. So
why is it a waste? Isn't good for the cop to know who's the town as well?
It's better if you check.
It's better this
if you check
the
mafia.
Yeah.
It is better, but it's not a waste. I mean, never a waste.
I think
the only waste.
Well, town for the cop to check you. You don't want to say, "Hey, check me," because that's a waste, right?
Also, Mango's kind of high priority. Kill.
Was the former rescinded? Side note, was the former
rescinded? Yeah, Mango.
I think having Mango is confirmed talent is as valuable as finding a mafia.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, until he gets killed like night two or something.
That's always a possibility. Yeah.
Eric, it was more of a joke to try and get you into the conversation.
What was it?
I said, Sheth's blinks per minute are approaching yours. How do you feel about that?
Oh, he's got glasses on.
Rob, can you tell a joke to get Alan into the conversation?
No, I have a question. I'm not a miracle worker here, Carlton.
I have a question.
Cameron,
I have a question.
Okay.
Just want to ask, joking aside, how, if you go, to the no one that we really want to lynch, are we going to lynch entries or not? Not joking, just wondering. Because everyone's saying, and I don't know if you guys are joking or not, but...
I think we're mostly joking.
Okay. It's a difference between joking off on a tangent and joking to, within the game.
Yeah,
you know, it's you're talking about information in the reaction. Game.
I haven't heard anything from Cameron.
I've been participating. I was gonna say. I mean, I have been a little quiet. What do you want to hear?
How do you feel about the relationship between Chef and Mango right now?
I have trouble reading into it either way. I think it very much seems like Chef the way he's doing it, and. I think that it is a little suspicious, but it's not something I can draw a day one read off of. And I think it's worth checking one of them, I think, at some point.
So do you have any reads on anybody so far? Who are your top three suspicious people at this point?
Top three suspicious people.
It's a tough call right now. We're still early in the game, I imagine.
I don't know. There's just a lot of people we haven't heard a lot out of. A lot of people. I don't really have any strong reads on anyone.
I'm not really.
Yeah, I don't know.
I'm not convinced by what you're saying right now. My reason being that we've heard most from almost everybody, save maybe two people.
Yeah, but that doesn't. I mean, it's hard to get a really strong read on day one.
No, my point was you said that there's a lot of people in the group that we haven't heard from yet, and I don't think that's true.
I guess.
Do you have any mafia or town reads?
Hmm.
have a town read on myself, but I think
only a read. How sure are you?
How strong is that?
Oh no, I'm not getting a mafia read from Unctuous, so I don't think we need to lynch him day one.
I think Cameron and Unctuous are a mafia.
Yeah, Cameron. Oh, I thought you meant Carlton. Sorry.
Everyone always like reads me as mafia on the first day or the second day, and they're never right. I'm just putting that out there.
It's fine,
like,
Cameron.
I'm pretty sure every single game I've played, somebody has been like, "I think Cameron's mafia," like, and then gone off about this for like 20 minutes, and then been wrong.
No, what you're saying is the law of averages says you're due to be mafia this game.
What? I don't think that's I don't think that's how probably.
No, what he's saying is what he's saying is we should keep lynching him day one until we're right. That's
Can we just do regames until we kill him day one?
So I mean, I want to rescind like I don't know about Crown being mafia, but I think Unctuous is actually mafia. So just want to put that's that. A weird out call. There.
And this,
I don't think so.
I don't think
so. Really?
I think so.
No, I don't think so.
I don't like the Cameron Unctuous thing. That was kind of weird.
No, I think that was Cameron on Unctuous more than Unctuous having any part to do with that. So I don't think there's like
that was the other way around.
I called Cameron out.
Cultural.
Yeah, but it was upon silence that I kept prodding.
Yeah, but I mean,
when Cameron was asked like, "Are you mafia?" and I said it kind of jokingly, but he was like, he didn't answer. He didn't answer directly. He didn't answer with yes or no. It was like, I don't know.
I don't think I heard you actually, to be honest.
He said he had a read on himself, not that he knew that he was.
How sure are you? And then he said, "I don't know again" or something. It was just a second time to answer kind of specially to me.
I mean, it was like, I obviously, like, I know I'm town. So responding to that question really seriously, like, of course I'm fucking town. Like, that would be more suspicious than just like laughing it off as a joke, I think, at least.
Are you worried? Are you really worried about how you're portraying yourself as town right now?
Not really. I mean, I am town, and I don't think I've done anything to this.
So why did you pick Unctuous? Like, out of the one person that you have a read on, why is it Unctuous?
Well, just I was just commenting because everybody had been talking about how, like, joking about killing Unctuous, and so I made it serious for a moment, and was like, I don't actually think that he's mafia, so I don't know. I wouldn't want to kill him, but I don't know. I mean, just thought I'd put it out there.
Do we have any formals?
I would like to talk to Eric. He's been pretty quiet as well.
I've noticed that's a bit weird too.
Just sitting back, tilted to the side.
Yeah. What's going on, Eric? You
I'm absorbing all you guys want to give me.
Yeah. So,
I don't know what my read is on Cameron. He's definitely acting sketchy, but I think it's more just bad town, perhaps. Sorry. I thought somebody was laughing. The people that are rubbing me the wrong way right now are Sheth, Rob, Carlton, and Ryan. But historically, my first day reads have been pretty bad. So
yeah, I heard you mention something about Carlton too when we said Cameron. Do you want to elaborate on that a little bit? Like, what are you getting as a read from Carlton?
This is just a gut read. It just something about him this game is just rubbing me the wrong way.
You know, because I thought he looked suspicious too at the very beginning, but that's gone away. Like I feel like it's normal Carlton now.
I don't think he's playing differently. Like he's doing.
He's usually like really quiet, and then he comes out later with.
Yeah,
you know,
Carlton always does this.
Like, what's suspicious about him right now to you?
Oh,
a less trimmed beard.
Carlton is salty.
Carlton looks standard at the moment. He hasn't really talked too much to try and actually give away a read.
I would actually be
quite
more
a bit so far.
No, I'm not saying that you haven't talked. I'm just saying that you talk. It's not like you've given a lot of information to give a read of mafia. Is all I'm saying at this point. It's day one. It's too early to make a call on that.
Yeah, you're my like 5 second like who looks funny, but that completely went away. So I'm curious.
That rubbed me the wrong way personally, and there's three things that have happened so far in the beginning of the game. I don't like nitpicking on people because they didn't know the rules of the game, because it's pretty easy to miss that. And Carlton and Ryan both did that, so that's one strike against them in my book. Sheth came out with a joke about Circle of Trust.
Completely serious. You mean?
He only jokes when he's mafia, man. He's serious.
That on top of that,
speaking a random person that wasn't talking. I personally don't like to kill off quiet people in the beginning because there's a good chance that it could be some kind of a role and they're quiet, whatnot.
Okay, keep going. I'll let you finish. Just remember, I have something to say.
And
don't you forget.
Rob is doing his usual thing. He did make one stand against Chef by pointing out that Chef likes to joke around when he's mafia a lot. But Rob also does that. He does a little poke just to distance himself away from the person, and then goes back to being quiet. So
you mean always on his mafia work, trying to say.
I'm saying he's not one to band with his mafia counterparts.
Okay.
I want to say something after Unctuous. So.
What was that third thing about Carlton then?
I had a third thing?
I thought you said you had three things.
Yeah, you did.
I said there were three sketchy plays really early on.
And one was from Chef.
I don't want to bandwagon. I don't want this to come off as bandwagoning. But while we're on the subject of Carlton, there's something we need to talk about in kind of a game general sense. One thing that Carlton and I talked about in Mafia Meta last week was, you know, should there be a free pass for players who have made themselves known to be strong late game players in the early game? And he said in his opinion that he doesn't feel that way, but he does take advantage of it. And I'm not, how much longer do you want him to be able to take advantage of, like, letting him be quiet early game? Because we know that he's a strong late game player.
I think the problem is we always said that we're not going to do it, but I mean, when you get to the point, we always find someone else that's more GC to lynch.
Well, I think
getting there right.
If anybody's played with me the last 2 weeks or like watched me play the last 2 weeks, I think you'll notice that I'm not quiet anymore. I haven't been quiet this game. I've been pointing out a lot of stuff because that's my new thing. If I see something I don't like, I'm going to point it out right away. So we're not in a situation where I'm going to be quiet and you have to worry about me.
You've been relatively quiet this game compared to the last.
He's been pinging like people.
I've been quiet when people are talking about me, because I'm not. If somebody's talking about me, unless they point out something that's patently false, I'm not going to interrupt them. I'm going to let them talk about me, because obviously,
you're dumb.
If I was Mafia and somebody's accusing me, I'm not like, if I try and like talk over them and not let them speak, it's going to look worse on me. So I'll let somebody speak if they want to have something to say. And Eric, I was interested in what Eric had to say about me. And I think that his points, like, while I don't agree with them, I think from his point of view, are valid for his point of view.
The reason I mention it is because those kind of early jabs where people don't know the rules are ways to get people eliminated easily and early.
Yeah, right, but at the same time, there's not much to talk about anyway, so I guess you might as well bring it up. I think it's just one of those things.
I brought it up because I didn't like it at all. Mango's done that before. Mango's done that before when he's been Mafia. He's pretended like he didn't know the setup.
Yeah, that's true.
Tiers of things you'd want to lynch for, I think Carlton being quiet and giving him respect as a good player is a lower priority than, say, someone who's not talking much. I'd rather let Carlton live rounds and kind of show his value later than someone who day one's not doing much.
Well, I'm surprised that Unctuous would say he wasn't talking much, because I thought he was talking a good amount.
I didn't think so at all.
I don't remember. I agree with Unctuous. I don't remember Carlton talking that much.
He's talked some, but there have been a lot more people talking. Like, he's also been applying pressure to people and making them talk.
Yeah, like, he's also, there's been games where he hasn't talked at all, and this isn't one of them. Like,
yeah, Carlton,
yeah, not one of them at all.
Not talking a lot are two different things.
I call it Drezic. Sorry.
Like my point is, it just didn't seem like he was saying very much, like compared to what Carlton last week did, for instance. Like it seemed like he was heading more towards in the direction of old Carlton as opposed to new Carlton. And I could be wrong. A lot of people are disagreeing with me, but that's what I noticed.
Maybe he just chose to use that build this game instead of his new build.
I just wanna say something really quick. So
Drezic had his hand up. Can you hold on for a minute?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thanks.
All right, so on the topic of Carlton, I haven't noticed him talking that much, but it's more than in other games I've played with him. In addition, we called on Cameron and Daniel Geese, and they haven't said jack since we called on both of them. They've said, like, a couple words each.
Wait, who's Daniel?
Raid on us. To be fair with Cameron, we just talk about Cameron and then switch subjects.
We called on Cameron when we talked to him. We didn't
What I'm saying, we just did is like 5 minutes ago and then start talking about another subject. Like, it hasn't passed like 4 or 5 minutes most.
What I'm saying is, if he isn't pointed out, he doesn't say anything. He doesn't have more or less an original thought.
Did you say Cameron or Kiwi doesn't?
Cameron. Cameron. Kiwi probably does as well, but he hasn't spoken anyway, so I wouldn't know.
I had things to say about like what we were talking about with Carlson, and I've been speaking up, but like Eric and everybody had and Unctuous have been talking like pretty consistently, like back and forth.
Wait,
and
who?
Carlson and stuff. So mm-hmm. It was like it's not exactly like easy to just jump in.
Just like while there's put your hand up, man, or like say something.
I mean, I was interested in what they were having to say because I thought it was an interesting discussion.
So right now, I just have a few reads I want to point out really quick. From the very beginning, I think that like when Kiwi's town, he kind of seems really town. At least to me, like the games where I've played with him, and I've been like, oh, I think Kiwi's town. He's come out like the way that he talks, like how quiet he is. I think those like really match up with how he's town. And I think him and Unctuous right now. Oh, and Eric stand out as the most town to me, and then Sheth like 75-25 leaning towards town. On the other hand, after that whole discussion, I really think Cameron's Mafia. I'm leaning towards Mafia for Rob, and I have this really, really like strong feeling about Jason with Anaya's Mafia. I have a really strong feeling on him. Like I haven't played with him much before, but I'm really strong. And the reason why is because at the very beginning of the game, he was joking around a lot, but as the discussion started getting more and more serious, he started playing a back-end role where he just like asked a bunch of questions that I don't think said anything. And the thing that tipped me over the edge was when he was like, guys, are we like serious about voting off Unctuous right now? Like, you know, aside from like everyone, it seemed pretty clear to me that we were joking about Unctuous, but he was the only person that brought up like, seriously, you know, should we vote off Unctuous? And I thought that really like tipped me over whether I thought Unctuous was town and Jason was Mafia. So I'm ready to formal if we can get enough votes.
What did you say were your talents again? Me and Unctuous and Chef?
Kiwi. Unctuous and Kiwi stand out as most town to me, with Chef being like 75-25, and then Cameron and Rob being leaning more towards Mafia.
Why do you think Kiwi and Chef are town? I agree with you on Unctuous, but why do you think?
Okay, well, just because... So if you believe me that I really think Jason with an eye is Mafia... there was a point in the game very early on where both Rob and him kind of jumped on Chef and was like, oh, you know, don't you joke around when you're Mafia, or like, that was Rob, not you, Jason. Rob was like, oh, you know, and then I think Jason with an eye asked him a question also, and I don't remember what it was.
I don't remember you. I asked him, how are you so sure the mango is down? Because he said that they're both down. That's all I asked. So I don't know. That's why I was jumping on him.
Yeah, that's right. But that doesn't say much, but I just noticed a correlation there. So that's why I'm kind of putting two and two together. So that's why. And then Kiwi is just like a gut read. Like I just feel town from him, I guess. So
you put in two and two together, but it may, like you're saying, it's five. I mean... First off, I was joking around, and everyone's joking around, and then I stopped joking around because everyone got serious. And when I asked the question about Unctuous, was because everyone was saying that, like, you get to the point later into the game where you don't have anyone to go for, and then last minute to go for someone else. And I just want to know how everyone feels for real, or if everyone's joking around, because I have been here for the last 2 weeks, and everyone has, like, a grudge against him, so I don't know what's going on. And that's why I asked.
So a lot of times when someone's Mafia, they try and ask blatantly, it's hard to explain. There's the Kenpachi rule or whatever, where he says something really stupid, and the first person to be like, hey, this guy is retarded, he's probably Mafia, let's kill him. Like, that guy is usually Mafia because he's saying something that's like obvious enough that doesn't need to be said, I guess. But I feel that way for Jason. Like, it's just kind of this weird read on Jason at the moment.
Are you saying that I'm the dumb guy that says something that someone's pointing at me, or are you saying that I'm the one that pointed at someone?
You're the Mafia one in that equation.
Okay, I get it now.
Oh, Kiwi had his hand up for a while.
So did Alan.
Go ahead.
Let's go one by one. Kiwi, go ahead.
Kiwi, what are you?
You're up first.
I didn't have anything huge to say. It just seemed like the town discussion felt kind of vague and directionless, which would lead me to believe that the more experienced strong town players early on might be more likely to be Mafia. It's not anything like specific on anyone. I don't know if anyone else is getting that feeling about the way the conversation is getting, but that was
normally how it is on day one.
I think for day one, it's been fairly productive. We usually get yelled at for going off topic, and that hasn't happened. We've been on point.
What does Alan have to say?
I was going to go off what you said. I didn't like what Cameron was talking about. I mentioned that earlier, with the whole business earlier. I did really not like that. And Jason, I also feel that, in his defense, I didn't like it because it was very similar to how he does it when he's Mafia. It's kind of, I don't know what he's talking about. This doesn't make sense. Kind of deflecty, that kind of a feel. And that's the vibe that I got off that. And on your town reads, I also agree that Eric is pretty town because he's playing very similarly to how he's played town in the past to me.
I know you have your hand up, Eric, but Bregor hasn't said shit.
I was about to say the exact same thing. Ryan, it's time for you to talk, dude.
Why? Look at him. He's so defenseless.
Why do we have to ask him to talk, though? Why can't you just talk up without asking him to talk?
So, the one thing that I've noticed this game is that Alan is playing a far different game than usual.
Sure.
Alan usually doesn't pay for not talking early. So, he's never, he doesn't have a huge incentive to talk early because he hasn't been lynched for it yet. So I just want to point out that Alan is playing a far different game this game than he usually does.
What's your conclusion?
What does that mean?
That he's actually talking.
Alan, so I did see one thing in chat when we were first going on the Unctuous thing. People in chat were saying Alan's defending Unctuous, their Mafia together.
I was defending Unctuous? Fuck?
Somebody was somebody was saying that in chat.
Did you see it happen or based on
I didn't do that.
I think chat wasn't listening.
I don't recall that. Alan was only defending Carlton.
They said he was half defending Unctuous. And then I don't know. I'm just telling you what I saw, man. I'm just telling you what I saw.
Well, does anyone else to tell me what I said about Unctuous?
I want to hear Ryan finish first.
Okay.
I don't remember.
Yeah.
It's Ryan a build-up.
Ryan was out of his chair for a little bit, so
I had to use the bathroom.
Sure.
Yeah.
No, I'm just saying you didn't know for sure if he brought it up then or not.
Right. And then so then right after that, the comment said Alan's defending this person, he looks Mafia. And then Alan started defending Carlton real hard, and I didn't the thought through my head, I don't know if it's right or not, was maybe Alan's defending somebody who's town now or somebody else who just whatever Carlton is, just to try and make him look town. So my thoughts right now are on Alan.
Is that it? I mean, is all your this first round just based on something you saw in chat?
No, I mean,
what do you think about me, Ryan?
You talk
about me for a little bit for now.
You're my hardest read of everybody. You're my hardest read of anyone. The second person, if I had to say I didn't like somebody, secondly, it would probably be Cameron.
That one.
I kind of second Cameron, but I've been. Go ahead, finish, Gregor.
No, I was done. I heard somebody try to say something, but it was muffled.
Carlton wanted to talk, I think.
Yeah, so you're basing that whole suspicion off Alan off something you read in chat, not something you observed in the game yourself.
So also, when I read it on chat, I looked at Alan, and the accusation in chat was about a paragraph long, and Alan was reading something for about 15 seconds while I was watching him.
I don't read chat.
I was reading chat. I don't understand that. Going off of something that happened outside of the game to draw a read off inside the game.
If you say chat tipped me off to something and that made me pay more attention, and while I was paying attention, I noticed this.
Right.
That's one thing. But if it sounds like that's not what you're saying,
it just that didn't happen. I didn't defend on
shit. Yeah, I don't think you did. I don't remember.
I don't remember that either.
So that pretty much is what I'm saying, Kimball. And to be honest, the reason I didn't come out with that is because I don't think it's very strong. I just was called upon and I wanted to say something, and that's the best thing I had.
So there's been some interesting dynamic going on between Unctuous, ZNF, and Cameron. And it's got me confused because every time it changes, I really liked ZNF's soliloquy. I don't know what you call these things.
Knowledge bomb.
Yeah. He seemed a bit anxious earlier, just the way he was holding his hands and stuff. He seemed a bit fidgety, but he was really calm when he was dropping his bombs. Cameron defended Unctuous kind of early on, which seemed a little bit weird. And then ZNF defended Unctuous from Cameron, saying like, look, just because Cameron's defending Unctuous, I don't think that's putting, you know, an attachment on Unctuous. And I've heard a lot of other people kind of getting town reads off of Unctuous. So of those three, I really feel like there's something going on that's sort of starting from Cameron that doesn't make sense.
Well, ZNF also accused Cameron of being mafia.
At least with regards to me talking about Unctuous, like somebody asked me, like I was asked for my reads, and I have a really hard time getting reads on day one. I haven't played mafia like as many times as most of the like really experienced people in chat, so I'm still pretty bad at getting released like early reads. Mm-hmm. But somebody asked me, like, what reads do you have? And I was like, well, I don't really think Unctuous is mafia. Like, I know we're probably just joking about killing him, but I don't really think he's mafia. So, like, that was one of the only reads I had. It wasn't necessarily, like, me going out of my way to defend him. I was just giving you all I really had at that time. Because everything else was just people had talked about, like, pointing out the people who just weren't talking that much or whatever. And
I just want everyone to keep kind of those three people's dynamic, you know, in mind as this goes on.
All right, so I guess I'll give my reads. So far, I think Eric, Ryan, ZNF, Kimball, and Sheth are likely town. Four people, if I had to choose the four mafia right now, it would be Jason, Rob, Carlton, and the fourth, I'm not sure. Possibly Cameron, I guess. Yeah, I guess Cameron.
So you think Chef's town now?
What?
You think you're good with Chef now?
Yeah.
We've been BFFs the whole time. Don't worry about it.
Dude, it was all planned.
Just don't do that.
So, Mango. Yeah.
Fucking Chef.
You're not the only one to point out Jason. What did you see? Made you suspicious of him?
I don't know. It's just nothing concrete. It's just the way that he's been reacting. And I've been looking at him when people are kind of bringing his name up as suspicious. And it just doesn't seem right. It doesn't seem like he's reacting as a town should.
From the people on your list, I would probably be most comfortable lynching Jason. I agree that I didn't like his, like, hey guys, are we gonna kill Unctuous? Like,
I mean, for me, my number one is actually Rob, but I'd vote for Jason as well.
Oh, shindigs! I didn't realize you were here.
So, are you not on Unctuous anymore? Because earlier you thought Unctuous was mafia.
He's not in either list right now.
He didn't say my name.
I'm still somewhat suspicious of him.
Now. I know, that's why I'm wondering why it wasn't in that list now.
Right.
I don't know, maybe the fact that everyone in my town circle doesn't think he's mafia, so that kind of swayed me, but my gut read initially was that he's mafia, but that's why he's in neither circle right now.
Yeah.
So, most of those reads are pretty much where I'm at. Other than the Ryan thing, I don't know what you're thinking with that, because you could say that you're not convinced that he's mafia, but I don't know at this point you can say that he's town. Like, I can't understand what he could have possibly...
There's a reason behind it, but I'll wait until next round. We'll see if I'm ready.
I just want to speak up because everyone's been talking about me, and I think I had cleared the issue about Unctuous before, but I guess I'll say it again. I just, like, everyone was talking, and I was really, like, chat over the past week and the other week about how Unctuous did, like, bad in the game or whatnot, and everyone was talking about lynching him. And I just want to be sure, like, I was getting the vibe, like, I wasn't sure if you guys are talking for real or not. So, I mean, I wouldn't use that against me. If you have other stuff that you think, like, what other stuff the Mango said, maybe I'm not reacting the same way since I haven't played in 2 weeks, so I'm not reacting the same way I used to react. I mean, if you want to use that, okay, but just asking about Unctuous is not really something strong to use. I didn't push for it, just ask people about it.
I feel like we kind of need to make a decision. This is actually kind of what I was talking about with Carlton again as well. And I'm going to bring it up. I tend to bring it up every fucking week, but we have to kind of make a decision whether we're going to try to base off who is going to be lynched on whether or not we think that they've given us enough to say that they're mafia, or if we want to try to go after people who are staying quiet. In this case, Rob's been relatively quiet. Kiwi's been pretty quiet. Like, there are quiet people, but at the same time, to me, I'm most uncomfortable with Cameron right now. I think he's like my read that I'm uncomfortable with and that I've been discomforted with since the beginning. But I don't want to give myself tunnel vision in that way. But
okay, guys, we're approaching 1 hour fairly soon, so it would be great if we could get a kill.
I just wanted to make it, so what are your feelings on Kiwi at this point?
He's in neither camp right now. If I had to like pick, I'd say town over mafia, but he's in the neutral camp.
The Drazig wants to say something.
Mango, how are you so sure that you'll live to the next day? Didn't say if I'm alive the next day like you usually do. You said I'll let you know next round.
Well,
that was, I mean, it might not be anything, but I just wanted to point that out.
Because
I also
I can't say right now, but you'll just have to wait until next round. That's all I have to say.
I don't.
Are you subtly implying your role so we shouldn't lynch you?
No.
I mean, like, just by saying that makes Mafia really want to kill you. Like
Drastic, like, you shouldn't even say something like that.
No, I think you're trying to imply that you're a role.
At the very least, what Drazik pointed out was a really good thing to point out. Like, you shouldn't, I don't know why you're saying you shouldn't have pointed that out. Like,
No. The pointing out thing is where he said, are you suggesting you have a role? That's like rules number one and two.
Yeah, like,
you should never do that. Yeah. Unless you're going to try and tip other people off and say,
don't ask
somebody if they're a role. What you do is, what I was going to say to Mango is, I don't like how you did that. I don't like how you said, oh, well, I'll tell you tomorrow my read on this guy. Like, I don't like the way Mango's playing at all right now. I really don't like that.
I don't
ask him to say.
No, but the problem is, if Mango actually was cop or vigilante, he wouldn't say things like that because it draws attention to himself.
Okay, well, this is just, that's like, Mango says this a lot, though. Like, I've played with Mango in real life, and whether he's town or mafia, he's said this kind of stuff.
I don't remember.
Mango has been living longer in some of these games than I remember, so I mean, he could just be confident. Yeah, like, I think Mango could just be like, well, I'm just going to say that, right? But, like, he's been living longer in some of these
games. There's no guarantee that Mafia wouldn't kill you if, like, he had a good read. Like, Mafia would want to kill him before he says
It's day one. No one has a great read. The reason why it's almost like good play for Mango to do that is because odds are, like, I have no idea, but Mango's probably no role. And now Mafia has to, like, be secretly wondering, hey, maybe he's a role. Maybe I should kill him. And that's great if he's no role, because then they kill a no role. So, like, this is just, like, higher level play that I'm sure Mango does and thinks about. And you guys are, like, making your reveal secret. Just so you
but
know.
If Mango's town, he's a really good town player, and he shouldn't be trying to get himself killed as town, because if he's town, him being in the game longer is better for town.
But no, but he's saving the cop, though. He's saving, like, the cop. That's what's, like...
Guys, can we drop it?
What would you rather have, a good Mango or a real cop?
There's nothing good that can come out of this by talking more.
Let's agree.
Okay.
Don't kill Mango.
I'm going, because I said this a while back. I said if I could garner enough votes, I would do it. So it sounds to me that at this point, Jason might be our best option. So I'm going to go ahead and formal him, because I think I have enough votes to do it. So I'm going to formal Jason.
Okay, well, what's like, I don't know what to defend against. So, I heard your accusation before. I heard what you said, and I defended already. The thing about Anshu's, I already said, I just want to make sure what people are saying, if they're like really joking or not, if they're frustrated about this play, or if, like, if you get to the last point, like 1 hour long game, if you're going to vote him or not, that's what I want to know. The reaction, I mean, I don't know, I haven't played for like 2 weeks. I'm probably reacting different from what I react when people said my name. Other than that, I don't think you have much on me to just go for it. I've tried to help as much as Aaron, like the next guy. I haven't been quiet and wait for someone to call my name and then give my reads and give like one read on someone that I read on chat or something. I've been trying to contribute more than people, other people here. So
got this. He's Mafia. Holy shit! That
what?
That's Alan calling you out. Alan says you're a little bitch.
Like, the way he's defending himself is exactly how he did it before. Like, he's trying to throw it on other people, and he's like saying a lot of things, but like not really anything substantial. Like, I'm getting huge mafia vibes.
Okay, so it's been just about an hour, guys. Do we have any? Do we have anything we want?
I want the formal.
It's next to formal right now.
That's what I mean.
Formal on
who? I'm trying to defend myself. And I'm saying, like, I don't think you guys should kill me because I'm really not mafia, and I can prove you more next round. Maybe like play more aggressively if you want, or ask more questions or something. But I just said it's a really good, bad move to town to just kill me right now because you're letting four mafia leaves the next round. And that's all I have to say.
He's not even giving us reads. See, we're good.
I'm
good.
All right. Do we have any words for or against him? All right, voting.
I don't know if he's our best bet this round. I'll just leave it at that.
Sure.
I think we should go through this vote.
Yeah, I think we should go through it, whether it passes or not, actually. I'm fine with it.
Yeah, of course you should say that. Like, the person wants to call me out and it's pushing for it and not anyone else.
I think either way it'll give me good information. So.
It's weird that nobody's defending.
Oh,
I just did.
Yeah, no one likes Chef said. Chef's a nice guy.
There's
though.
No chef in specific. There's no defense, like Chef said, in specific to him. I agree with Chef in that there's better.
It should be a pretty close vote. Let's do it.
Yeah,
I personally don't like the vote, but I'll see how it goes.
All right, voting in 3, 2, 1, vote. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 against 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7-7 is a tie.
Okay. Oh. Cop, I checked Jason. He's mafia. So.
What?
We didn't vote.
BS. That's BS.
Oh my god.
Okay. Let's. So
that's why I said.
Why would
not
you come out after he? Now he's now like the vote hasn't
that's
passed.
BS.
Now.
I mean.
Why
first
would
off,
I think
first
it was
off,
really good.
I'm the subject. I'm the subject. He's talking about me. First off.
We can't
do anything to you.
Well,
I have, like, I can speak. First off, I'm not the cops, so I'm not going to counterclaim. But, I mean, why did you check me out of everyone in this game? You don't even know me.
Exactly, that's why.
I think that was the point of the check.
Exactly, because I haven't seen you before.
That's
a good
reason.
So, I just
want to... trust you. I mean,
so, okay, I just want to say a couple things. So, first, we should look at who didn't vote. Me, yeah.
So
me being one of them, I didn't vote.
Did anybody write down who voted?
I want to point out that Rob didn't vote, which was in my mafia circle.
Carlton has a list. Let's go through.
Everyone, people didn't vote.
That's yeah, Carlton didn't vote either.
I didn't vote. The people that didn't vote are Unctious, Mango, Chef, Rob, Eric, and me.
And me. I didn't vote.
Obviously.
Say it one more time, dude. I'm writing it down.
Unctious, Mango, Chef, Rob, Eric, and me.
I think we can... So I was more concerned about who was going to vote because I didn't think he was mafia. But now that the cop has come out and said he's mafia, I think he's more use in assuming that the people that didn't vote for him are more considered mafia.
Yeah.
The people that didn't vote for him are considered?
Because that's the reason why I said... It should be a close vote because I wanted Mafia to think that they could potentially swing it over.
Yeah.
I just hope the real cops are not waiting.
Because it's so close, though, right? I don't think all the Mafia are among those that didn't vote, though.
Yeah.
I think at least one Mafia voted because you can't know as Mafia which way it's going to go, right? Because this was a very close vote. Like, I thought even with me not voting, it would have passed. Personally,
I kind of thought so too.
I think people were holding back, which was
okay. So let's talk about for a second. If we do not believe ZNF, do we think the real cop should come out? Hypothetically,
yes. I mean, if he has a mafia, then you gotta confirm townie.
If he has another mafia read,
that's two mafias.
If real cop comes out, not only does that like. Prove that ZNF is either like really shitty town or
it's
mafia.
I mean, it's a creative way to get Jason's town as well. I mean, we've seen town players fake cop as well. It's weird that the cop would have come out after Jason was exonerated and before there was another lynch even on the table. Like, that was just the weirdest timing ever for a cop.
Oh, I think that was good timing because we said earlier one cop equals one mafia.
I don't know about that.
We have a video.
I don't know about that, but the point was I just wanted to see
Kimble.
Who didn't vote and who voted.
That's right, Kimble.
We have a Vidge. The possibility of the Vidge getting killed tonight is
it doesn't matter his shot his shot
doesn't matter the shots of it, yeah. Yes, the possibility of the Vidge getting killed tonight before we found out about Jade, you know, that he's a cop, is higher than the possibility of the Vidge getting killed during the day while he's coming out. So, like, if he want, right. I said that in a very confusing way, but if he wanted to make sure the Vidge can kill him tonight, he needed to come out.
Alternatively, Foolish was Vidge. That would suck.
Yeah, but there's a little possibility. Wait,
so let's go back to Ryan's point. I think if a real cop exists, they should come out like
Yeah, dude.
I agree.
Green cop.
I agree.
Yeah, sure. Anyone who wants to claim whatever.
I don't know if I agree. I'd rather just wait till next rounds because like ZNF's gonna be dead 100% either way. And like if ZNF isn't dead next time, then you can come out cough. I'd rather prefer that.
I think so. Let's talk about if we have our vigilante alive. I think I for one believe ZNF, and I think our vigilante should kill Jason.
Yep, I agree with that too.
That is like
I don't think
okay, so. In the meantime, guys, it's been more than an hour. Do we have any other formals?
I did.
Well, okay.
Oh, of course. I mean,
I don't think he's cop. I think there's a real cop here and just waiting for the next day. Do they have another read?
So,
and then
I just
well, obviously you're gonna say that, but
I just want to mention something.
Basically, why the cop should come out now is because not only would you catch ZNF as a fake cop, you'd also save Jason because he's most likely gonna die in the night.
Yep.
Yeah, I have a super good read that Eric Smock, super good read on that, guys.
Can we actually get harder facts on what is happening in the game up to this point with Jason with an eye? Because I know Carlton has notes. If we trust ZNF, we know that there are people that he's been interacting with that we need to talk
about. I think Anxious, for one, is town.
Well, I think ZNF should be coming out because from his lens, he's been watching Jason for an hour now and seeing his interactions with everyone. Right. So. Is that where your reads were coming from, or were you poking?
Yeah,
like,
yeah, that's where all my reads were coming from. That's why I thought Stress was clean. That's why I thought Unctuous has been telling this entire game, right? Because immediately after saying like, "Oh, are we serious about you know killing Unctuous?" I was like, "Okay, I'm sold."
Just want to know.
So right. But I checked.
So ZNF, if we're gonna believe that ZNF is right, should we move forward with having him pick someone?
Well, here's what I want to suggest. I suggest that we look
at
one of the people who did not vote to kill Jason, and we draw from that circle. The thing that worries me is that a lot of town-ish looking people are in that group.
Yeah.
The biggest non-town person I see in that group to me would be Rob.
Yeah. What?
Somebody had a non-town.
I would vote Rob off in an instant
right now. Do we have a formal on Rob then?
Wait. Let's listen. Wait, can we hear what Carlton has to say first? I want to hear what Carlton has to say about
how the game's gone so far, right?
With respect to
in regards to ZNF and Jason. I have back in like probably halfway through the day. When ZNF came out with his reads, Jason was on his Mafia read. Yeah. Even back then. That was before... Yeah.
That was the first thing he said,
Cameron, Jason, and Rob.
Yeah. He had Unctuous, Eric, Kiwi, and Chef. He said 25-75, or 75-25 on Chef for town. There was one other point that he said something that he kind of looked at Jason earlier on. I mean, it kind of backs up. Like, unless he wrote down at the start of the game that he was going to target Jason and fake claim, everything's kind of lining up to support the real claim.
Cool. So these are the four people that have put serious suspicion on Jason throughout the game. It's Sheth, Alan, VNX, and the other Jason. And interestingly enough, Sheth is the only one of those that did not vote for Jason.
Right. What does that mean?
That means that there might be a meta play that he was trying to do.
Mm. That's a good point.
So ZNF, who have you been able to spot out? Actually, ZNF is going to die tonight. For sure.
He's dead, so might as well. Like,
I'm gonna formal Rob.
Formal on Rob.
Yeah, I was
more suspicious than Chef.
Yeah.
I feel like you're just saying
Chef because he pointed you out.
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
He pointed me out?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He pointed me out, I think.
I don't remember that. Nobody's
too long ago. No one pointed at Eric. Sheth pointed out at Kiwi because Kiwi wasn't said Sheth, anything.
Oh, he said Eric right Kiwi. After the vote. Yeah.
You guys, do you want to talk about this or do you want
to? No, you guys got to give Rob a formal defense. Everyone, let him give his defense.
I mean, it's about an hour long day one now. I think I've been a strong town presence, especially towards the beginning. I haven't talked in the past 10 minutes, in 20 minutes maybe at most, but I think I was very strong at the start of the game. I don't understand where my play would lead me to believe as being suspicious. I think I started getting scrutiny after I didn't even defend Unctuous. I just didn't like the very early coming out of Mango and Kimble saying, oh, let's kill Unctuous. And then right after that, they kind of like were like bandwagoning with each other, and I just came to say that it didn't feel right to me. But I think that's when I started getting, you know, some scrutiny amongst the group. Beyond that, I think there's stronger lynches than I. I don't think what I've done anything to show that I am not down. I think Geese, except for, you know, after we had to wait like 20, 30 minutes or so while he was eating to call him out. I think he hasn't really done too much since then. I think also that Drazik, the first time he really came out with his comment was like, isn't it funny that Cameron and Geese aren't talking? And like he hadn't talked yet really, so I thought that was kind of ironic. Other than that, I really don't, that's kind of my straightforward defense. I don't know. Any questions for me? Any comments? Anything they want to ask me about?
Yeah, I'm going to go directly against what Rob said and say that he didn't have a strong presence at all, like anywhere. That's just me blatantly refuting what he said. Yeah, anyway,
I think he was a strong presence. No,
I think at the beginning of the game, and Unctuous was disagreeing with me because once Unctuous started getting under scrutiny, I was one of the other big names getting tossed around. So it makes sense to kind of deflect towards me and have that stance. I think it's been an hour long day. So if in the past like 40% of the day I've been talking too much, I'm sorry, but I think I was good for the first 30 minutes reasonably. I mean, if that's my defenses, I haven't been talking. You could find easily a lot of people who've been talking less about me, talking less than me. So,
yeah, but
talking less than you. I mean, it's my defense. Doesn't make them more suspicious.
I'm not saying it makes you more suspicious, but if that's the basis of what I'm getting lynched on, that's my only counterclaim to that. The lack of the vote. Well, I think there's better
ways just because of the key narrowing factors.
Mango, what do you think of this?
Yeah, but Mango is the one who formaled me and he didn't vote, so I don't understand why he gets exonarrated from this.
Here's what I'll say about this situation is that I didn't vote, but I said I wasn't going to vote for Jason ahead of time just because I wasn't sure at that point.
I
did say it. But I don't like the people that didn't vote. The problem is that I don't like Mango the most out of those, so it bothers me that this formal came from Mango, but I still don't like it. I still don't like Rob because of that, the way the vote went. I wish somebody else had done this formal.
In all fairness, someone said if there's any defense for Jason, and Sheth spoke up and said that about, you know, he didn't like the lynch too much, and I agree that there was better people to lynch. I second in that. I voiced my sentiment before the vote happened, so it wasn't like I was trying to metagame a close vote. Like I had my stance before the votes were even beginning.
Of course you had your stance because you're not voting for your fellow mafia.
Are you really gonna like talk the most now, like as you're trying to lynch me? I don't get it.
Do we have anything else we want to say against it?
Rob and me all saying that we didn't like the vote before it went in, it could have made it look very obvious to people, like to Mafia, that, oh, I don't think this vote's going to pass, and they could have withheld their vote.
Not votes. Yeah,
okay. that's kind of what I wanted to happen a little bit.
We got to keep this on Rob, guys. Is there anything for or against Rob directly?
Are you going to rescind Mango? No?
All right, voting in...
I have something to say for Rob. Before we vote. Yes,
okay. Rob, you're fucked. Rob, you're fucked.
That's it. GG.
GG.
You might be the cop, but you die tonight. And I will get shot. And you guys are going to lynch Rob. But you're never going to get Ryan and Kiwi. Because they're going to win the game for us.
This is not about Rob, specifically. Voting in 3, 2, 1, voting on Rob.
That was okay. Awesome.
Oh my God.
Rob, you die. Everyone, go to sleep. Everyone go to sleep. We're going to run a 30-second commercial while everyone sleeps so we can reset the counter because we go by the Twitch counter. All right, you guys know what to do. Mafia, tell me who you want to kill. Cop, tell me who you want to check. Vigilante, tell me who you want to shoot, if anyone.